Hey guys, what is going on? It is ORINX here, back with another video on the RCF. So what we are going to be doing today is actually going to be applying some overlays to the front bumper right here. It's like a garnish cover in gloss black. As you can see, I got them all right here. And then we're going to be doing an aggressive style rear bumper. I don't even know what they call this, rear bumper, fender, garnish, something like that, that goes right in here. That's also going to be gloss black, and on both sides, obviously. And then we're also going to be tinting the taillights. I believe it's a 30% tint or something like that for the taillights, so should be pretty dark. And we're only doing the white part, or the clear part of it, which is the reverse light. So those should definitely stand out a lot and give me more of an aggressive styling. So I got all these overlays from somebody that I found on Instagram. His Instagram is called Blue Bat Overlays. I guess he custom cuts and prints all of these decals for various types of cars. So before I do go ahead and start the process, I have a few things to do. First of all, I wanted to shout out one of my buddies, Bullets Garage. He has a GSF and he does a lot of the same stuff I do. I see he does a lot of performance upgrades, appearance upgrades. He actually has a overlay from the same person for this check mark here. He did it in yellow, which I thought looked pretty good. That's actually how I got this idea to get these decals and stuff. And he just got a new carbon fiber front splitter too. So he's doing the same thing I am, but with the GSF. So if you guys really want to see more Lexus F car content, go check out his stuff. I would really recommend it. I know during these COVID times, it gets really boring. So yeah, we're both making sure that we can keep the content up for you guys. I'm gonna put his name on screen right now. Once again, it's Bullets Garage, and I will also put a link to his channel right down in the description, so that'll be easier for you guys to go check it out. Just click that and go show my buddy some love. And another thing I have to do before I start the video is definitely have to give the car a car wash. I know you guys probably can't really tell, but it's very dirty. It rained the other day, and you can see there's dirt all the drip down here, so we wouldn't want to be applying these decals over a dirty, nasty RCF. So we're gonna go ahead, start it up, and I guess we'll roll the cold start as usual, pull it out, wash it, and then start putting the decals on. Okay, so you guys just witnessed only a fraction of the very meticulous process that goes into my car washing. I'm out of breath. I've been doing this for probably like, I'd say maybe like an hour and 15 minutes. You can see the sun is almost down. We're gonna go ahead and try to apply one of the overlays. I'm thinking this one first. So after all of that, we are finally ready to install. We have all our supplies here. Comes with instructions as well. And instructions just say, you know, these are the supplies that you're gonna need. And also says that it recommends a wet application. So what we got, so we got our heat gun, we got our soapy and water mixture in this spray bottle. I have some isopropyl alcohol and distilled water in this that I just sprayed it and wiped it down with to clean it extra good to make sure there's nothing stuck on there. And then we got our squeegee. All right, it's time to start. I'm gonna set you guys up over here. And then I guess fast forward this. So everybody, at the end of that last clip that you just saw, my camera actually fell off the stand. that was holding it to record the time lapse of me putting on this piece here. And then right when it fell, I picked it up and it said that my camera died. So I was like, all right, that's enough, screw it. At this point, like, we're just not gonna show this time lapse. But I did complete it and it looks very good. I'm gonna show you guys now. So this is what we're working with. I cut it perfectly so it fits all the edges very nicely. I'll show you guys here. Might have a few fingerprints and dust on it, but I really like it, and that definitely does look good. I like the way it kind of looks like something's like melting or flowing onto the splitter or onto the ground. It is currently 1:59 in the morning right now. Obviously, my sleeping schedule is completely wrecked, so I guess I really am not that tired. So I guess I'm just gonna head over to the rear now and start applying the next piece because I ain't got nothing else better to do. Here we go. Alright, so here's the final product of the rear fender overlays. Looks really good. And as you can see, I didn't put it all the way on the edge, which I don't know if you're supposed to or you're not. I feel like with it sitting down a little bit, it shows more of like a popping effect. So that piece was definitely worth it. I love the way that it looks. And I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side now. I'm not gonna do a time lapse of that one or anything, but you guys will see the finished product when I'm done. All right, so just finished the second rear fender overlay. Looking good. I think I like this better than the front one so far. This is what it looks like if you were behind the car. Pretty noticeable, makes that little wide angle stick out more. And yeah, now all we have left is the headlights, so we're gonna move on to that now. Alright, so the taillight tinting is complete. Looks exactly how I thought it would, or actually even better. It's pretty dark, not completely black, it's a little bit see-through, but definitely matches well. The last thing that I have to do is trim the edges. You guys can see I have some overlay all up here and stuff, so I got my knife down, I don't know where it is, but I'm gonna set you guys up here for the time lapse of me trimming it, and then we'll see you when we have the final product. So everybody, here it is, the completed job. Took me a few hours total, but I'm gonna start with the lip, and we're outside now so we can actually see how it looks in the sun and all. Lip looks amazing. That gloss black is really shining, you can see. And I wasn't really sure how I liked these at first or if I liked them. It took me a minute to get used to it, but it definitely added a nice touch. And I'm glad that I got these. You can see tail lights are looking good. Trim them all up and they're perfect. Just the right amount of tint. And then got these too. Oh, neighbors are all looking at me, that's great. Very happy with the quality. Hopefully it lasts long. I mean, application was easy. I think anybody could have done this. I'm terrible with vinyl. I'm terrible with applying decals or anything like that. And I did it. So you could definitely do it for yourself. And I paid, what did I pay? Like 50 bucks, I think, for all of this. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, make sure drop a like on the video. Drop some comments down below. Subscribe if you are new. We have a lot of new content coming. Next things that are probably gonna happen to the car are probably going to be the diffuser we've been working on, and then I was also thinking about doing these reflectors, and actually make them light up lights just like the red ones up here. So yeah, that's it for this video, guys, and I will see you next time. I'm out. Peace.